Hey, everybody, I'm Hillary Atkin from the Atkin Report. I'm excited to welcome Kari Matchett from The Night Agent on Netflix to this edition of Hillary's Happy Hour. Kari, how are you doing?
Great, great. Thank you for having me.
Kari, congratulations on the success of The Night Agent. It's a 10-episode suspenseful thrill ride that is the top show on Netflix. And you play President Michelle Travers. Tell us a little more about the storyline.
It's a political drama. It's set around the White House, and it is sit on the edge of your seat, thrills and chills, and it's a wild, magical carpet ride that Sean Ryan, who was the creator, and his writing team took us on. They were incredible scripts to read, and the show is even better than the scripts were. So it's a pretty thrilling story, all about, centered around the White House.
I totally agree with you. And Gabriel Basso stars as FBI agent Peter Sutherland. Let's take a look at the trailer.
Hello?
Runs deeper than you realize. And farther than you can imagine.
The Night Agent starts with a bombing that FBI agent Peter Sutherland tries to stop. And near the end, there is another bombing that agent Peter Sutherland tries to stop. This time centering around your character in an extremely dramatic sequence set at Camp David. So tell us more about that, Kari.
Well, it was a wild, wild ride. You know, there were explosions and there were special effects and there were stunt people. It was a huge production day, a number of production days. And, you know, those things are always actually dangerous, in fact, as well. So there was a lot of safety measures in place and nobody, you know, everybody's just trying to do their best work there, but there's always, everybody's on the edge of their seat when those things are happening because explosions are going on. So, you know, it was an exciting few days to shoot those episodes, that's for sure.
I want to compare your character to one of the other few female presidents on television, and that is Cherry Jones, who was the president of the United States on 24. And she called her POTUS a combination of Eleanor Roosevelt, Golda Meir, and John Wayne. How would you describe President Travers?
You know, when I was doing my research on presidents, I took great inspiration from the presidents that I personally admire. And one of them was Abraham Lincoln. He was a real visionary. And to me, he's upheld as one of the great peaceful presidents. And I really saw my character being that. Someone who had a vision for peace and for harmony and for cohesiveness within the country. And so I also took inspiration from Obama. I read his Obama's latest book, and that felt like his philosophies felt like they were in line with the kind of president that I was trying to portray. And then on another level, I think that, you know, having a powerful woman, it was, I would say maybe Amelia Earhart doing something that no woman has done before and doing it with style and grace. So yeah, Abraham Lincoln, Obama, Amelia Earhart.
I love that. And again, The Night Agent is such a thrill ride. I love the genre of spy thrillers. And we were mentioning 24. And Sherry Jones, who played the president in part of that incredible, groundbreaking series. And you were part of it in season 6. So I want to hear more about that.
Well, you know, I was a huge fan of 24 before I was ever on it. And so being on it was a thrill. The creators were incredible. It was one of the best experiences I've ever had working with people who I felt like were not only genius at creating story, but they were genius at listening to the actors. I would go in and talk to Howard and say, this is what I think my character should do. And they listened. It was phenomenal. They listened, they were responsive, and they wrote such incredible things that I was so lucky to be a part of. The other actors that I worked with were great, and the crew was amazing. I didn't get to work with Kiefer. We were in different factions in 24, but it was definitely a highlight and remains to be a highlight of my career.
Talking about relationships on the show, one of the interesting things to me in The Night Agent was your very complicated relationship with your chief of staff, Diane Farr, played by Hong Chau. She's part of a conspiracy plan, and with your own vice president. So tell me more about your relationship with her as the backbone of the story that develops.
The relationship between Hong's character and mine was that Hong held my hair while I threw up in the college sorority. You know, we have a deep, long friendship. We have a history that takes us beyond the fact that we're now in the White House together. And it just was so much fun to play with, rather than just, you know, talking about policy or talking about what or wasn't happening. Playing that we were college besties was incredibly rich and interesting.
Also, in the final episode, there is an incredibly dramatic scene where you tell Peter Sutherland the truth about his father, or at least part of it. And you also make sure, without giving away anything, that his future is secured. So can you tell us a little more about the significance of that scene?
Well, without giving away too much, I will say that it sets up season 2 beautifully. Peter goes from one level to another level with the help of President Travers.
Congratulations on the pickup of season 2, which happened so fast after the show originally debuted.
I mean, I know nothing about season 2. I will tell you that. I mean, it's early, early days, so I truly know nothing. Having the gift to play the President of the United States was such a thrill. It's a thrill as a woman. It's a thrill as an actor. But, you know, the opportunity to walk in those shoes, it was just so much fun. And it was so interesting to kind of wrap my head around that level of responsibility and importance in the global scheme of things. So I would love for that just to be fleshed out a little bit more in season 2. And I don't know. Hopefully it is. I have no doubt that whatever Sean Ryan and his writers write will be interesting, though.
Absolutely. I think, you know, people know Sean from creating The Shield, and he has that fan base that he's carried with him all this time. Mm-hmm. I look forward to more of your powerful depiction of the President of the United States, who has such grace under pressure, Kari.
Thank you.
And I want to thank you so much for taking time out to be with me on Hillary's Happy Hour. And I want to raise a glass to you and your continued success.
And I raise a glass to you. Thank you for having me today.
Thank you, Kari. Cheers.
Cheers.